Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're going to be talking about common problems and reliability of GM's 4.3-liter EcoTec3 engine, which is the successor to the 4.3-liter Vortec engine. The 4.3 EcoTec3 is also known as the LV3 and was introduced in 2013 and was the base engine in most of the Silverado and Sierra 1500 work trucks all the way up until it was phased out in favor of GM's new 2.7-liter four-cylinder turbocharged engine, which is able to make a little bit more power than the 4.3 EcoTec3 with two less cylinders due to the addition of a turbocharger. The 4.3 EcoTec3 is actually a very strong engine, but there are a couple common problems as with any car, and so we're going to go ahead and talk about those as well as the overall reliability for this engine. Most of the problems here tend to be with the fact that this is a direct injected vehicle that comes with a number of what I would call common problems, but they do tend to be more so maintenance items and things to be aware of rather than things that would cause any concern for owning one of these. The first thing that of course we have to mention is active fuel management or displacement on demand. Active fuel management has been around since the mid-2000s and has been causing a lot of problems with GM's Vortec and EcoTec engines in the way of lifter collapse and lifter failure. The 4.3 definitely fares a lot better than the 5.3 and 6.2 liter EcoTec3 engines, which tend to experience more frequent cases of lifter failure. That's not to say it doesn't happen and that it's not something that is potentially concerning for these engines. They just tend to have a slightly better AFM system than the larger V8 engines do. Outside of engine failure though, there are a couple other common complaints that come with AFM, and that's a lot of hesitations and kind of sluggishness that you get from your engine transitioning from V4 back to V6 mode. So while it can cause some serious problems, it's also something that if you can notice it, it starts to become a little bit of an annoyance when you put your foot down on the gas and you feel your car having to shift back into V6 mode before that power is available to you. So both for reliability concerns and overall for just improving the drivability of the vehicle, we recommend disabling active fuel management. We actually have our own product to do that, and that is the Boost AFM disabler. This is a simple plug and play device. It plugs right into your OBD2 port and basically just sends a message to your engine that says don't go into V4 mode. So this will keep your 4.3 liter in V6 mode 100% of the time, which is going to help prevent any issues with lifter failure, but it's also going to remove any of those hesitations, sluggishness, or kind of rough shifts you get from your vehicle going from V4 to V6 and back all the time. This is a $149 product. You can get it on Amazon or on our site boostafmdisabler.com. It's absolutely worth it in our opinion because it does greatly improve reliability and just the overall driving experience of these newer EcoTec3 engines, as well as the older Vortec ones that have it as well. So to sum it up, active fuel management is not a huge problem on the 4.3 liters, but definitely for peace of mind and better driving, it makes sense to go ahead and disable it. Moving on from there, there really aren't any other what I would call truly common or catastrophic problems with this engine. As I mentioned, it is direct injected, and so there are a number of things that come along with direct injection, and that is going to be issues like carbon buildup. The fuel injectors do clog from time to time. The high pressure fuel pump does fail from time to time. And you run into some issues with the PCV valve failing. So ultimately, clogged fuel injectors and a failing high pressure fuel pump aren't frequent enough for me to call common, but they have happened, and they have happened on some of these vehicles around the 100,000 mile mark. That's generally just a problem that comes with a direct injected vehicle. But generally speaking, these engines should be able to last to the 200,000 plus mile mark with very few issues, and certainly no catastrophic issues, so long as you don't run into any lifter related issues, which aren't as common on these engines. Ultimately, these are very strong engines. They don't come with a whole lot of problems, and there are a few simple things that we can do to help improve the reliability and prevent any issues with the direct injection or with the active fuel management system. And those two things are getting our Boost AFM disabler device, and installing a catch can on your vehicle. A catch can will prevent all of the dirty, oily gas from being recirculated back into your intake system, which is in part what caused gunk up your intake valves. And so that'll prevent issues with carbon buildup, which will then help keep your injectors a little bit cleaner and safer, and it'll help prevent any issues with your PCV valve. And so ultimately, those two things can make this already reliable car even more reliable. But ultimately, no concerns here that would raise any flags for me in terms of buying one of these, even that's at higher mileage, or owning one and planning to take it to somewhere even around the 300,000 mile mark. These are strong engines and can make it there with just your handful of typical maintenance items along the way. Anyways, guys, if you appreciate this video, please click that like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned as I'm going to be doing videos on the 5.3 EcoTec and the 6.2 EcoTec3 engine soon.